So the president of the United States is a man who prides himself on being a winner, a man who brags about his strength and being a fighter, a man who never met a red carpet he didn't like and basks in praise and cheers. Well, today his bubble was burst on the world stage, literally.
Today I stand before the United Nations General Assembly to share the extraordinary progress we've made. In less than 2 years, my administration has accomplished more than almost any administration in the history of our country. America's so true. Didn't expect that reaction, but that's okay.
That is what happens when you continually go back to the well of adoring crowds and supporters. Reality suddenly just smacks you in the face. World leaders essentially telling the emperor he has no clothes. Laughter was the last thing President Trump expected when he made that boast. You heard him say so. He said it himself. Leaders from around the world definitely did not respond with the kind of reaction that he's used to getting from crowds of supporters at campaign rallies. It is no coincidence, by the way, that the vast majority of those rallies, look at that map, are held in red states, where the president can be assured of the reaction he wants.
Guided by these shared values, we've already accomplished more than anyone ever dreamed possible. A year and a half, that's all it is. We have not let you down. I'll never let you down, ever. We've passed the largest tax cuts and reform in American history. Somebody from the news, I won't call it in this case fake news because he turns out to be right, said Trump is one of the only people ever that actually accomplished more than he promised. And it's true. I accomplished. I'm a politician, I guess. We've already made tremendous progress, far greater than I would have thought. I will tell you this in a non-braggadocious way. There has never been a 10-month president that has accomplished what we have accomplished. That I can tell you. That I can tell you.
Largest tax cut? Not true. Accomplished more? Not true. Remember the wall thing? Mexico is going to pay for it. But true to form, President Trump says he actually did very well in his speech today at the United Nations. And even though you heard him say he didn't expect to be laughed at, now he's claiming he was in on this joke.
How do you think your speech went today?
I think really well. It's gotten very good reviews, certainly, and I think it went very well. Oh, it was great. Well, that was meant to get some laughter, but it was great.
Even if that were true, the podium at the United Nations is not a comedy club. Now, if there is one thing that Donald Trump doesn't like, well, let's face it, there are a lot of things Donald Trump doesn't like, but I'm not sure I really have enough time to run through the list. But he really, really doesn't like being laughed at. He certainly didn't like it sitting stone-faced at the White House Correspondents' Dinner in 2011 when President Obama roasted him from the podium.
No one is happier, no one is prouder to put this birth certificate matter to rest than the Donald. And that's because he can finally get back to focusing on the issues that matter. Like, did we fake the moon landing? What really happened in Roswell? And where are Biggie and Tupac?
Well, some say that's the moment that sealed the deal for him. He would run for president and get the respect to which he feels he's entitled. And he couldn't have liked it much today, given that he has been complaining for years about everybody around the world he thinks is laughing at us.
I know lots of folks in China. They think we are the dumbest son of a b**ches in the world, all right? They think our representatives don't know what they're doing. They laugh at us behind our back.
They're sitting around their table just setting the price of oil and laughing at us.
The world is laughing at us. We're like a bunch of patsies. The president of China comes over and we have a state dinner for him, honoring him. What a wonderful guy. And he's laughing all the way back to China.
We are a whipping post. We are a laughing stock as a country. We're not respected anymore.
When do we beat Mexico at the border? They're laughing at us, at our stupidity. We've got China, and they laugh at us. They think we're stupid people.
Well, given all that, it's probably no coincidence that President Trump, just hours after looking like the butt of a joke with the whole world watching, it's probably no coincidence that he went on the attack today, slamming one of the women whose accusations threatened to derail his nomination of Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court. One of the key promises he made to his supporters, by the way, and he tweeted just 1 week ago that the Supreme Court is one of the main reasons he was elected. Now, it's important to note that we don't have evidence that proves what Christine Blasey Ford says Brett Kavanaugh did to her when they were both teenagers. We don't have evidence that proves what Deborah Ramirez says Kavanaugh did to her when they were both students at Yale. And Judge Kavanaugh denies the accusations. But I want you to listen to what President Trump said, particularly about the accusations of Deborah Ramirez.
He's never been here before. He's never had any charges like this. I mean, charges come up from 36 years ago that are totally unsubstantiated, and now a new charge comes up. And she said, well, it might not be him, and there were gaps, and she said she was totally inebriated, and she was all messed up, and she doesn't know it was him, but it might have been him. Oh, gee, let's not make him a Supreme Court judge because of that. This is a con game being played by the Democrats.
Well, unfortunately, it is really no surprise that President Trump would mock the very idea of a woman's accusations derailing a man's career. Remember this, at least 15 women have come forward with a wide range of accusations against Trump himself, ranging from sexual harassment and sexual assault to lewd behavior. And remember that Donald Trump is the man who was caught on tape saying this.
I better use some Tic Tacs just in case they start kissing her. You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. You just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the pussy. I can do anything.
So now, in what may be a measure of just how serious all this is for Donald Trump's presidency, he has decided to do something he hasn't done in more than 586 days. He's decided to hold a solo press conference tomorrow, just hours before Christine Blasey Ford testifies against Brett Kavanaugh. You know what they say? Timing is everything.